Well, my friends, I know you're all feeling bleak because it's the end of the greatest reality series the universe has ever seen. But it's not all bad news because we've reunited all of those cheeky shipwrecked scamps so that we can pick those bones we've been waiting to pick for 20 weeks. This is Shipwrecked, The Aftermath. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the sharks and the tigers. Oh, sorry, if I may. And Jeff over there in Jefftopia. It's a cheap gag. Jeff, come join us, brother. Come join us, Jeff. Okay. Thank you, Jeff. First up, sharks, congratulations, did incredibly well. Luke, can I ask you, what was it like watching the final episode there? Emotional?
It was extreme. It was very extreme.
Was it proper extreme?
It was proper extreme. And, yeah, it's not like home, is it? So
I need to speak to the lady of the moment, Jenny. How difficult a decision was that? Because you were kind of sorted either way, yeah. Monetary-wise.
Well, what I thought, so I'm in the money either way. But once I got out there, everybody was fantastic. But I do feel now that I did pick the right team because they're all fantastic.
Even now.
I'm going to stay, yeah.
Let me ask Nip, quick question. You seem different. What did you spend the money on?
Well, I thought I'd invest the money in a couple of assets, so, yeah.
Baby, you look incredible. Tigers, let me ask you a quick question. Alara, who's that belong to? Jenny? That's you, babe. Alara, would you have done things differently with the Jenny situation? Do you think you pressurised her to go into the sharks?
No, I don't think so. I think we're just very genuine. We just showed her what we were about, and that was it, really. You know, yeah. No pressure or anything, like there was on Joe. Sorry about that, Joe. We just tried our hardest, yeah. And obviously, you know, we weren't the team person.
Okay,
yeah, cool.
Okay. Well, I've taken a trip down memory lane recently and compiled a list of my top 10 shipwreck 2006 moments. Take a look at 10 to 6. They're rather good. The music.
Yo, yo, and away we go.
Sometimes I sit and wonder about the journeys we go through.
My name is Profanity. I'm from the Cardiff vicinity, hailing from the Splot community, full of pent-up hostility.
I count each grain of sand for you.
And big up the one time, we'll see you very soon. We hope that you stay happy as a balloon.
The tears.
Sorry.
Is that right?
Cry all you want. We've got each other here at the moment, so we're doing all right.
The chicken.
We're going to kill two chickens today. We're going to take it up there and chop its head off.
Filthy Katie.
Katie, exactly how long has it been since you've washed your hair?
This is the second time in 9 weeks.
Oh, Lord.
What? That is just... rinse.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, my.
Hanky Panky.
My name is Madame Spankinson.
Oh, baby, I like it.
Get your tongue round that.
The willies are out.
Work up, like, tongues down each other's throats.
Oh! All right! Yeah! Clap your bad selves, that was fantastic. Okay, I want to talk couples. Richie, where's the wife? Has it been smooth sailing or stormy weather since you left the island?
It's been good, even better than when we were out there, but she didn't want to come today because she said she couldn't be in the same room as me and Jeff. It's one or the other. She'd go with Jeff. I'm not lying. She'd go with Jeff.
She did fancy Jeff. Let's talk about another couple. Let's talk about Somerset's Ryan and Marissa. What's going on between Gareth and Nipia? What happened? You're just going...
No, well, we got back and things are a lot harder when you get back than they were out there. There's a lot more going on in your lives and we just decided to leave it as friends.
Okay.
So.
Gareth, a lot harder for you?
Yeah, a lot harder. things are different when you get back here. A lot of pressures. Okay. There's a lot more people around as well, so.
Of course, of course.
Not in that way. I'm not really in that way. Cut that.
We'll cut that out. One other love interest I want to talk about. Chris, your wrist was bandaged for a lot of the time on the island.
There was a lot of...
subsided.
Lonely nights on Tiger Island, you know.
Of course.
Take care of yourself.
Can I have a show of hands really quickly, please, of who is single at the moment out of all of you? These are some very, very eligible people. I'd love to go more into that subject, but let's stop right there. Let's move on now. Here's 5-2 of Shipwreck's top moments.
Matchgate.
Jeff has hidden the group's weekly ration of matches, and he's enjoying watching his fellow sharks search for them.
I think I'm going to get so much trouble.
You watched all of us suffer and stood there singing, "Always look on the bright side of life."
The heist.
We've been plotting to sneak over to Shark Island, swipe their luxury items, and basically bring them back here for a bit of a party.
Is that all we've got in there? Hold on, it's all our luxuries, isn't it?
John's sacrifice.
For breaking the rules also, you guys also having to choose a member of the Shark team to move to Tiger Island permanently.
There's one person who is 100% shark and you'll never turn them, and that's me, and you're getting me.
James George.
Hello.
Right, girls makeup, we've got enough, let's go.
Thinking at the moment I could be in a lot of poo.
Comedy table.
It hurts to eat. My lips are so bad now.
You're like so much cooler, whereas I'm more camp.